SARS coronavirus 2 is a new virus, so we're learning about it as this outbreak unfolds. The scientific, medical, and public health communities are discovering, learning, and rapidly producing and synthesizing a flood of data. We're working to get you accurate, current, and useful information.
First, we needed to figure out where the novel virus came from. The earliest cases occurred in Wuhan, China. Epidemiologists interviewed the first several patients and their families, and they found a common thread. They had all visited the same market in the city before getting sick.
Then, we needed to know how the virus spread and how fast. When people who had never visited the market became sick, we learned that this virus was transmissible from person to person. We now know that the virus is transmitted in respiratory droplets, either when you come directly in contact with droplets from a cough or a sneeze or someone talking excitedly, or when those droplets land on a surface, you touch that surface, and then touch your nose, mouth, or eyes.
Next, we need to know who is most at risk. The good news is that 80% of cases result in mild illness, like the flu. It's miserable while you have it, but you'll make a full recovery. The bad news is that 14% of cases need to be hospitalized, and 6% will require intensive care. Unlike the flu, which is worst in the very young and the elderly, COVID-19 is most severe in older individuals, while children seem to experience only mild infections. A review of thousands of cases in China found that the risk of needing hospitalization or intensive care increased with the age of the patient. This pattern has been consistent as the pandemic spread to Europe and America. Those with diabetes or pre-existing heart and lung conditions are more likely to have severe disease, regardless of age. Why is this important? Most people won't get very sick, but we need to plan ahead for those who will. We need to allocate healthcare providers and medical equipment, like ventilators, to where they will be needed most. Learning who is most at risk and identifying the early symptoms that indicate progression to severe disease has helped doctors in China reduce the death rate from infection from over 10% at the start of the epidemic to about 1% now.
We also need to know how fast this pandemic is spreading. This allows us to know how to prepare our hospitals for an increase in illness. A key to knowing how fast this is spreading and who is at risk is to test, test, test. Testing serves two important roles. First, testing allows us to identify cases, get them into care if they need it, and isolate them quickly to limit their ability to spread infection to others. Second, without testing, we can get a very biased picture. We might miss people or places with low access to healthcare. And if we don't know where infection is, we may misallocate resources. This means we tend to allocate our response to places that already have good access to care, and the most vulnerable among us may be left behind.
There are still many questions that the scientific community is working to answer. For example, a bright spot in this pandemic is that children have largely been spared. They rarely have severe symptoms, and very few have died, though we don't know exactly why. We are learning that kids do get infected and can spread the virus to others, so it's important for them to practice physical distancing, just like the rest of us. We don't yet know how long your immune system can protect you from reinfection. Recent studies have suggested that after infection, we produce antibodies that should protect us for a while, but we don't yet know how long those last.
What do we do when we don't know? Scientists and doctors rely heavily on past experience. With a new virus like this, some of our past experience is extremely valuable, and some of it will be irrelevant for this new virus. We welcome new evidence and work to rapidly adapt policies and practices so that our future actions are well supported. Learning is a fundamental part of the scientific process, so as our understanding changes, we do everything we can to communicate what it means for you.